Rangers, and welcome to Ranger Ruby YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be going over the 10 national parks that I want to visit. Let's go ahead and dive right on in. So in today's video, I'll be going over the 10 national parks that I have not already visited that I want to visit. These will be only national parks, so no national historical sites or other historic preserved areas by the National Park Service. And I'm going to give you some fair warning. There will be some major national park geeking occurring, so you have been warned. Okay, so starting at the bottom with number 10, it is Everglades National Park. The only reason that this isn't higher on the list is because of mosquitoes, which are one of the many banes of my existence, and I am just not ready for the Everglades level of mosquitoes. But other than that, it's an iconic park. You got swamps, you got alligators, you got boats, you got snakes. It's just a really cool place that I want to visit that's a habitat that I've like never seen before. So number 10 is Everglades. Number 9 is Theodore Roosevelt National Park. This park is in North Dakota, and it not only has a place that Theodore Roosevelt lived in for 2 years and spent a lot of his life on, but it's just a really cool environment again. It's like the Badlands Plains of North Dakota, and I've been to that area, region of the United States, and it's just so interesting to look at, even though it seems like a pretty boring plain landscape. Plus, there's a lot of cool critters and creatures there that are commonly seen inside the park. So number 9 is Theodore Roosevelt. At number 8, we've got Redwood Forest National Park. Not only is this park an icon of the state of California, but the world's tallest trees, which like, that's pretty cool, I'm not gonna lie. You don't need to say more to convince me. Redwood Forest, let's go. And number 7 is Acadia National Park. Now this one, it's personal. I used to live in the state of Massachusetts, and we were really, really close to Acadia National Park, but we never got to go. So it is one of the many reasons that I want to visit Acadia National Park, because like, I was so close, yet so far. But also because of its incredible scenery landscape. Also, I've heard it's a pretty family-friendly park with campsites as well as hikes, so it sounds right up my alley. And number 6 is Rocky Mountains National Park. This one's also personal because one time we were, I'm not joking, a half an hour drive away from the park and we did not go. I have never let this go and I never will until I visit this park. All of the pictures I see are stunning, which means that in real life they're even more stunning, and it's just a type of scenery that I love to enjoy and look at. Plus, it's pretty fun during the winter time, and I love wintertime sports to watch as well as, you know, do, so definitely up there on the list. And at the halfway point, we've got number 5, and I kind of cheated on this one and snuck in 2, so this is really 11 parks, but Sequoia and Kings Canyon. Not only does this park have some incredible scenery and hikes and trails that I've heard a ton about, but it's also got the biggest trees in the world. So apparently trees are a big selling point for me, and I want to see them because they've been on this list quite a bit. Okay, so now we're getting to the really fun parks that I really, really want to visit. So number 4 is Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. Okay, 2 things. One, it's in Hawaii. I would just go to Hawaii even if I weren't visiting a national park. And 2, volcanoes. I don't think I've ever seen a volcano or been on a volcano. And you get to do both of those things in Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. Plus, it's one of the tallest volcanoes and mountains in the world. Also, it's got an incredible culture that I've never seen or experienced before, and I would just like love to see and learn so much about. It's got incredible flora and fauna that you literally can't see anywhere else in the world. And it's just, it's such a cool place that I definitely want to visit. Okay, now, so number 3. Actually, here's the thing. Number 3 and 2, they're pretty interchangeable. I love both of these parks so much, I just can't put one above the other. So when I say number 3, I really mean number 2. When I say number 2, I really mean number 3. So just keep that in mind. Number 3 on my list, but it could be number 2, is Yosemite National Park. And I could literally spend all day talking about why Yosemite National Park is like, what I want to visit that. It is a crown jewel, it's just incredible, but an incredible reason is Yosemite Valley. Not only is this just like sheer granite cliffs, valley with incredible scenery, but it is like the reason national parks exist. Yosemite Valley was the first protected piece of land by the government, and even though Yellowstone was the first national park, Yosemite Valley was like the first protected area, like Yosemite National. It's just so historic. John Muir, like so many people fought to have this park protected so that I could see it. So I feel like I should, you know, see it. And Yosemite Falls is the tallest waterfall in the continuous United States. There are just so many reasons why I could visit Yosemite National Park. So we need to move on. And number two is Glacier National Park. Not only is this like the kind of scenery and wildlife that I just love, like when it'll be very similar to Yellowstone in that aspect because they're in like the same area. But like when I visited Yellowstone, that was like so aesthetically pleasing. I could have just sat and looked at trees all day. And I could do that in Glacier National Park. But also it's got some incredible fauna because of the glaciers and the fresh water. It's got some incredible lake views as well. And it's also got some incredible glaciers. That is something that I so desperately want to see. And especially since like, especially in Glacier National Park, they're kind of melting, which is a pretty big problem that they're dealing with. Like when the park was first created, there were hundreds of glaciers. And now there's like 20. So we need to get on that. Glacier National Park, let's go. And park numero uno is the Grand Canyon. Come on, are you really an American if you haven't seen the Grand Canyon? Just kidding, you actually are. But like, oh my word, every single person that I've ever talked to about the Grand Canyon that's been there has said it's nothing like the pictures. You have to see it in person. And that's the same way I feel about the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone when I visited that. Like, the pictures were nothing. You cannot understand the experience unless you've been there. And so I know that I'm missing out on something with the Grand Canyon. Plus, you can take mule rides down in the canyon. You can whitewater raft through the Colorado River. There's just so much stuff that you can do. And it's the Grand Canyon. This is like the landmark of the United States. So yeah. Well, everybody, that is the end in today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any other national parks that you would like to visit, be sure to let me know in the comment section down below. Be sure to hit that red subscribe button and the little bell next to always know when I post new videos. And thank you so much for watching again. I shall see you next video. Bye.